Johnson spoke with current and former agents today to see how they handled domestic terrorism.
18 years since the worst terrorist attack on U.S. soil, the FBI says their main goal is to prevent the next 9/11 and stopping smaller-scale attacks.
People are looking more and more for an ideological motivation to commit violence.
FBI Special Agent Grant Mendenhall says the Indianapolis division is constantly investigating terrorism-related threats.
A dozen or more on a monthly basis.
Doug Kuhn, CEO of Veracity and former agent, says the numbers seem normal.
Indiana is most likely similar to other states in the Midwest.
In 2018, Marlon Hicks of Crown Point was sentenced to 15 years for distributing information on explosives and poisons to use in a terror attack. In June, a judge sentenced Akram Musley of Brownsburg to 100 months in prison for attempting to travel to join ISIS.
Communications became between people that were interested in foreign terrorist organizations and their ideologies, had more ready access to that information.
The FBI says that's the role social media plays in homegrown violent extremism. People born in the U.S. who never left the country are radicalized online by a foreign terrorist organization.
You can reach anybody anywhere in the world and talk to them at any time. And they do their recruitment pitches, you know, they do things very methodically. They're accepting of these people that for whatever reason are not happy in their current situations.
The FBI looks for three pillars before they can launch a domestic terrorism investigation.
First, there has to be a potential violation of a federal law. There has to be a threat of force or violence. And third, it has to be motivated by some type of ideology.
There are a number of factors that make it harder for investigators to determine a motive. On one hand, ever-changing technology and easy access to social media. On the other, a mix of ideologies coming together.
There have been, and probably will be more, mass casualty events in the United States that you can't explain.
The FBI is still asking, if you see something, say something. No matter how big or how small, they say it's up to them to determine that. In the newsroom, Darius Johnson, Fox 59 News.